there's always a special atmosphere when the Czech Republic face Slovakia in ice hockey. It's not just the Czechs and Slovaks are ice hockey addicts, and the two Central European nations are united, and it's Czechoslovakia. The team won four silver and four bronze medals at the Olympic Games, not to mention Universiade gold on home soil. In 1987, the two teams met on Thursday night in the time. Fans were treated to a shootout. Their nerves seemed to get the better of the players. Slovakia missed their first attempt. Peter Gapper shot saved by the goaltender Thomas Kral. The Czechs could not take advantage. Dominik Matula missed his effort. Slovakia missed for a second time. Peter Bolton seeing his shot saved. The Czechs disappointed. David Radzina with a shot saved by Igor Zubora. Slovakia finally scored through forward Martin Kalinac. Babka's shot saved by Slovak hero Kral. Vital win then for the Slovaks, now well placed to finish in the top two. Slovak goal with 22 saves. Women's ice hockey is relatively new to the Winter Universiade. Canada, again, a big favourite. Took on Russia. Palacio Pagini versus Ghana. Six teams into the competition and played the round-robin group to decide the semi-finalists. Canada humiliated Spain 21-0 in their first match. The first goal came in the 6th minute. Laura Brooker of Wilfrid Laurier University. Scoring in this game. in the second minute of the second period. Russian goalie Anna Pregova made 51 saves on a busy night for her. Sensational display in a losing course. 20-year-old Moscovite studies at the Russian State University of Physical Education, Sport and Tourism. On this match, with a head held high. Russian defender Yulia Sadikova sent to the sin bin for a couple of minutes. Howie James Draper saw Canada score three in the third period as the Russians seem to tie up. Third goal after 41 minutes of play, Amanda Perkins. Managed to limit the damages, but Canada clear favourites for goal here. Alexa Normor had two assists. The fourth goal came in the 58th minute from Gabrielle Davidson. University of Western goal to Kelly Camp with 10 saves. Shutter for a start. 59th minute, Christina Capozzi, a student at UBC, made it 5-0. Great Britain have the unenviable task of facing Canada next time. USA also have 2 wins from two. It's an emphatic fashion from the players from North of the border. USA has Canada in the ultimate game of the 15th. 5-0 win. To figure skating action from Gaccio Arena in Trento. Nansong led after the men's short programme. The question was whether the Chinese skater could hold on to his lead after the free programme on Thursday night. Akio Sasaki of Japan did a fine performance in the free. Meiji University student, the big winner of the day. After his short programme, Sasaki back in 6th place with a score of 67.69 points. He climbed 3 places to grab a medal. Sasaki performed 2 18s by Roberto Fonseca and Martino. Sasaki scored 135.97 points. 3rd best of the day, gave him a total of 203.66 points. Sasaki overtook countryman Yoji Soboy, who was 3rd overnight, but could only score 107.43 in the free program, only the 17th best of the day. Nagorde Gorchkov of Russia held on to 2nd place after the free program. Gorchkov, who studies at Leskaft State University in St. Petersburg, performed superbly to an interpretation of Gary Moore's The Prophet. The Gorchkov family has something of a tradition at the Universiad. His parents won a bronze medal in the Winter Universiad in Belluno in 1985 in the figure skating pairs programme. And the 20-year-old now has also won a Universiad medal in Italy, keeping up the tradition. He took home silver. Indeed, Gorchkov was the top performer of the day with an impressive 142.79 points. Total over the 2 days, 213.52. Disappointment though for his countryman Zan Bush. He scored 133.66, but was eclipsed by Sasaki and stayed in fourth. So Nansong from China had an overnight lead of nearly 11 points, and he wasn't about to lose his advantage. Didn't have to take too many risks performing The Mission from legendary Italian composer Ennio Morricone. Song ranked up 139.14 points, comfortably the 2nd best of the day. Gold medal, 220.7 points for Tokyo, 7.18 ahead of Gorchkov. Song studies at Beijing Sports University. At 23 years old, an experienced campaigner, a 3-time champion. He won bronze in the Asian Games in 2011, silver at the 2010 Junior World Championships. This arguably the biggest win of his international career. Before the competition, favourite Denis Ten of Kazakhstan, the World Championship silver medalist, forced to pull out of the competition after injuring himself in the warm-up. That opened up the field and Song took full advantage. After picking up gold, Song said he was happy but not super satisfied with his performance. Nevertheless, the first gold for the large Chinese delegation in Italy. They're the results then. Gold for China, Nan Song. Russia takes silver, Japan with the bronze.
Vi preghiamo di alzarvi per l'inno della FISU e l'alza bandiera.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Now, 27 athletes were in contention in the women's 1,500 metres speed skating competition. This is at the Basilica di Pini Stadio. Not part of the calendar 2 years ago, one of the optional sports introduced by the organisers. Women competing in six other events, 500 metres, 1,000 metres, 3,000 and 5,000 metres, as well as a team pursuit. The 1,500 meter discipline introduced into the Winter Universia program in 1970. Rovaniemi in Finland. Let's look at the key action then. Poland and Russia. Second place went to Natalia Cervonka of Poland. She studies at the University School of Physical Education in Krakow. 25 years old. She ended up 0.14 seconds behind the winner, Bo Rum Kim. Cervonka won a bronze in the Polish Nationals back in 2007. Cervonka beat Evgenia Dmitrieva of Russia, who's 23 years old, studies at the Cherepovets State University. The Russian 1.62 seconds behind the eventual winner. Cervonka and Dmitrieva went in the 14th pair. Poland have a gold medal winning tradition in the 1500 metres. Katarzyna Wojcicka topped the podium in Turin in 2007. Dmitrieva wins the first ever medal in this event for Russia since the breakup of the Soviet Union. So silver for Poland, Russia taking the bronze. Time 2 minutes 2.33 seconds. Gold medal. Well, that was won by Bo Rum Kim, 20 year old from South Korea, studies at the Korea National Sports University. Celebrating the biggest win of her career. She would win this one in 2 minutes, 2.19 seconds. One of the pre-race favourites went to the 15th and final pair with Camilla Farestveit of Norway. And a superb performance it was too. It's the first ever gold medal in the women's 1500 metres for South Korea. Best performance so far, two silver medals. Lee Jong-yeon in 2007 and Ok Jong-sun in 1972. History then for Kim. Fourth place would go to Miho Takagi of Japan, 1.83 seconds behind the winner. Top six completed by two skaters from South Korea too, Dongyoung Park and Shin Yong-young. But the date belonged to Bo Rum Kim. 202.19, enough to take the gold. So confirmation of the medals, Bo Rum Kim, taking the gold. She was 0.14 seconds ahead of Natalie Tiavonka of Poland.
Republic of Korea.
Evgenia Dmitrieva in third.
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the victory ceremony for 1500 meter ladies.
Three biathletes were dreaming of a medal ahead of the 20-kilometer individual race in Lago di Tesero, a site well known for hosting cross-country skiing competitions. Russia won the last two gold medals in this event, Alexei Trusov 2 years ago, and Artem Gusev in 2009. Biathletes from Russia, no doubt favourites, to bring home more glory. Now, this discipline made its debut at the Universiade in 1983 in Sofia, Bulgaria. Success in the Universiade has proved a launching pad for a number of biathlon greats. Saver, Thomas Sikora, and Nazareva. This course included a climb of 630 metres. One of Russia's hopes, Sergei Klyachin, ninth biathlete to start. He completed the first loop in 11.383, 11 minutes 38.3 seconds. Student from Tchaikovsky State University, looking in good form early on. He was in sixth place after the first loop. And from there on, Klyachin would dominate this race with a superb display of shooting and skiing. He led from the second loop to the fifth and final loop. Clear skies and temperatures just a little below freezing made for near perfect conditions. Back in 1983, seven countries and 34 athletes set off with their rifles on their backs to take part in the first university biathlon competitions. For many years, Soviet and Eastern European athletes dominated the sport. Alexander Mingalev of Russia had a slow start, but got better and better as the race wore on. He climbed from 18th after the first loop to 4th after the second loop. Mingalev divides his time between training and studying at the Tobolsk State Institute of Pedagogy. Mingalev, the only biathlete whose shooting was perfect on the day. Now, four men's events in biathlon are at the Trentino Universiade. The others are the 10-kilometer sprint, 12.5-kilometer pursuit, and 15-kilometer mass start. Also one mixed event. Skiing techniques, all the athletes required to ski using the skate technique, most suitable for carrying a rifle, weighing a minimum of 3.5 kilograms. Serb hopes in Friday's 20-kilometer lay with Milanko Petrovic, a student at the University of Kragujevac. Petrovic leading the race after the first loop by more than 25 seconds. He dropped to sixth after the third loop and fight back to get the medal. Good day then for Petrovic and Serbia. The Klyachin, the undoubted star of the day. Just one shooting error from a standing position on his last visit to the shooting range. He came home in a time 51 minutes 56.7 seconds. What a performance from Klyachin. His countryman Mingalev didn't miss from the range. He came in fully 1 minute, 1:31.3 seconds behind the winner. 53:28 his time.
E benvenuto anche per la Russia, Alexander Mingalev, second place for Alexander Mingalev, Russia. Second play for Alexander.
La volta della concorrente.
Petrovic finished third, 1:39.4 behind the gold medalist. Petrovic, the best skier, with the serve let down by four penalties. 53.361 his time. Tomáš Krupčík from the Czech Republic was fourth, but some way back. 2:01.9 behind the winner. Four Russians in the top six. Alexander Ogarkov and Alexei Kornev. But Klychin dominating this one, and he takes the gold.
Kilometri maschile.